Okay, dear children, in the previous class we have discussed about the properties of rational numbers, and today I will discuss about one more property. First I have discussed about that closure property, and now I will discuss about the second property, that's name is commutative property. Yes, I will take the commutative property on addition operation. Yes, first I will consider the set of numbers, that is whole numbers. Addition operation on addition. Okay, I will consider two whole numbers. That commutative property is a plus b is equals to b plus a, right? This is the commutative property on addition operation. Yes, you take here that on addition operation commutative property is a plus b is equals to what? B plus a. A and b, these two are the any two whole numbers. That whole number set, it starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so on up to infinity. Okay, these are the whole numbers. Okay, that whole numbers are A and B. Yes, in the place of A you take 2, and in the place of A you take 3. Okay, not only 2 and 3, you have to take any whole numbers. Okay, yes, I will take here A equals to 2 and B equals to what? 3. Yes, if you have to substitute in this equation, what will happen? A plus B is equals to 2 plus 3 equals to B plus A equals to 3 plus 2. Okay, 2 plus 3 is equals to 5. 3 plus 2 is equals to also 5. Here, this is LHS and this is RHS. Now we got LHS equals to RHS, but this 5 also the whole number. The 5 also whole number. This is belongs to the set of whole numbers. Therefore, the whole numbers are commutative under addition operation. The whole numbers are commutative. Therefore, you have to write here the whole numbers are commutative under addition. Okay, yes, like this you take any type of whole numbers, any whole numbers, so you have to substitute in this on addition operation. Here if you get same whole number, if you get LHS equals to RHS, then you have to write these whole numbers are closed, then commutative under the addition operation. This is about the what? Addition operation. And then next I will take subtraction operation. Subtraction. A equals to same number you take it 2 and B equals to 3. Okay, subtract A minus B is equals to B minus A. These two are equal? No, unequal. It means you have to write here. Okay, once you put the given values and verify is it equal or not. Okay, A is equals to 2 minus B is equals to 1, 3. And B is equals to what? 3 minus A equals to 1, it is there here? 2. Okay, 2 minus 3 in the sense minus 1. 3 minus 2 in the sense plus 1. This minus 1 is not equals to plus 1. Therefore, the whole numbers are not commutative under subtraction. Okay, yes, it means already we have said about addition operation and one is multiplication operation. Yes, now I will check. Is it committed to or not under the multiplication operation? Here you take multiplication. Multiplication. Same numbers. A is equals to 2. B is equals to what? 3. Right? A into B is equals to B into A. Okay? A is 2 and B is 3. B is 3 and A is 2. Okay? 2 into 3, 6. 3 into 2, 6. Yes, these two belongs to the set of whole numbers. Set of whole numbers. Right? It means the whole numbers are committed to under multiplication. Okay, and next division operation. Division operation. A equals to 2 you take, and then B equals to 3. Same numbers you take it, or any numbers you can take it. Okay, A divided by B is not equals to B divided by A. A divided by B is not equals to B divided by A. A equals to what? 2. B equals to what? 3. Is not equals to, then B equals to 3 and A equals to what? 2. Okay? Therefore, the whole numbers are not committed to under division. Okay, yes, after completion of this you have to check it for integer sets and rational number set. In tomorrow class I will discuss about the commutative property on rational numbers. You have to check it and verify the integers also, that integers are commutative or not under addition operation, subtraction operation, multiplication operation and division operation. Okay, thank you.